All right, I'm here with my old friend, Ricky Carmichael. You were on issue number one cover. Remember
that's
that?
Right. Absolutely I do.
Yeah,
we had some good times. I had that maroon Chevrolet. Remember that?
He remembers. Do you remember the day in Florida when you're riding and you kept breaking the cylinders off your bike because you flexed the frame?
Yeah, the lugs.
And we're on the way home and you got a 20-piece chicken McNuggets. And you ordered. Yeah, you did. You did. And you're all. And she's all, what kind of sauce? And you're all, barbecue. Remember that? You remember that?
I don't remember the 20 piece.
No, but you're all, don't tell my mom. Huh?
Well, if you said it, then it's true. So, hey, we had some good times, though.
Yeah. That was right after.
Was that 97 or 98? No, it was 98.
I think it was right after you blew your thigh open with a foot peg, remember?
Oh, no, that was 99 then.
Yeah.
Dude. We're both getting old.
Yeah, I'm older.
No, we're not getting old. We're getting experienced.
Experienced and wiser, right?
That's right.
All right,
that's
so right. Tell me something wise for the camera.
Dude, not so you put me on the spot.
Yeah, knowledge from the porch.
Well, let's see here. Do unto others as you want them to do to you. How about that?
Oh, that's like... That's like a Sky Mall poster or something, isn't it?
I don't know what it is, but treat people the way you want to be treated. And just remember, you might think you're the baddest dude, but there's always somebody out there badder than you. So,
all right.
My man hooked me up.
Let's talk about the farm a little bit.
Yep.
What kind of treasures are buried 6 feet beneath the ground of that place?
Actually, a lot.
Yeah.
A lot.
Works cowies.
Works cowies for sure. Unfortunately, though, they were smart when they came there. When I left Cowie, went to Honda, they destroyed them all. They beat them all to death. So they're like non-usable.
Yeah.
But there are a lot of cool artifacts there.
Buried. And,
yeah.
Buried under the dirt, right?
Definitely buried. And I still am not 100% sure of where it is. Because my dad just says, I put it over there, bury it where I'd bury everything else.
Yeah.
But, the factories, they would destroy everything, so it couldn't be used, obviously. So,
nice.
It's good, though.
You want to know what my favorite memory of visiting you at home is? Getting kicked out of that golf course. Do you remember that?
Is that where we had the par 3 course, and I ran the golf cart?
Too close to the water or something? And the guy kicks us out, and you're all... I've been kicked out of nicer places than this.
Oh, yeah. So, yeah, we were at this par 3 course, right? And I drove the golf cart way too close to this little pond, if you will. And the guy, like, you guys need to get out of here. And I ripped the line off from my buddy and said, I've been kicked out of better places than this. So, that was cheap fun back then, man.
It was.
You know, it was cheap fun. It was, we had some good times. You were there for the early years, and talking about the farm, things have changed, you know, riding facilities and stuff now compared to back then. I feel like my place, other than Ezra's, we were kind of the originators of having a full-blown practice facility. So I see all these other facilities. It's amazing what they're doing. But, you know, I think the history that the goat farm has is pretty cool.
Yeah.
You know, and... we got what you need to get the job done.
And it's crazy because you're still producing champions out of that place.
We try to. You know, it's tough. You know, there's a lot of good talent out there. That's what's cool about the sport right now is I don't feel like there's a full-blown standout guy. You know, and that's what's so fun for me to watch. I have a lot of respect for these guys. I know how hard they ride, how hard they train, and it's really enjoyable for me to watch.
Cool. All right, buddy, thank you.
That's it?
I want to drink
That's
this
all
beer.
We got?
I want to drink this microphone
what
now.
About,
so.
How's your? I want to talk about how's your mountain bike career?
Dude, I've given up the dream of ever being good at racing mountain bikes.
Why?
Because, you age up, and you think they get slower as they get older.
No, dude.
They get faster, dude.
Dude, I will say, cross-country mountain biking is the biggest cherry-picking sport I've ever seen ever in my life.
Totally.
If you think that you're one of my races, I raced a slower class than I probably should have. I'm like, dude, I'm full blown like cherry picking. Meanwhile, I have like three guys. This is when I was in really good shape, still racing. And I have like guys just blowing by me. And yeah, it didn't make me feel as bad then, but they cherry pick so bad. And it's
worse
deceiving.
It's worse deceiving. Than Mammoth Motocross, junior class, right?
Well, I never spent much. Is that how it is at Mammoth Motocross? Well, there you go then.
Wait, here's how bad it is. Last year, in the 48-year-old class, I got sixth. So this year, I actually trained hard, right? Went there in the 50-year-old class, and I got 25th.
See, that's wrong.
Bad.
Mountain bikers. Dude, what's the deal? Come on, man.
Stop. You gotta be a stand-up guy like this, dude.
I love it.
Right on.
Thank you. Yeah, no problem.